Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Captain's Draft 3.0 presented by Dota Cinema and Moon Duck TV Winners Bracket Finals. The winner of this series, and in particular this game, will move on to the group stages for Captain's Draft 3.0 as we are into our last three rounds of the qualifiers. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome here on Moon Duck TV. We're in Complexity versus Mama's Boys, game number three. Boy, there are a lot of good heroes in the pool, and we'll get to that in just a second. Before we do, guys, of course, my name is Mott. With me today is Pit Mickle, our German god, who is the observer and producer for almost every Moon Duck cast that we do. Of course, we also have, on top of that, Grant, famous for his Dr. Pepper Wizard Savagery. Grant, how the hell are you, man?
I'm doing great. Game three, ready to watch some North American versus European Dota. Only my favorite, you know, because you got all the different angles of who, when, you know. I don't even know what I'm saying right now.
I got you. It is pretty nifty. There's a lot of different players, a lot of Europeans. It is North American versus Europe, but there's only two North Americans actually in the game, both on Complexity's side. So Complexity is more European than it is North American now, but they're still North American at heart, I guess, to a certain extent.
So. Yeah, they're all living here for a bit now. They were in the dominated the Shanghai qualifiers. They didn't even just win it. They just dominated those Shanghai North American qualifiers, and they already get Queen of Pain Tusk. They're looking like a CM team right now.
This is looking maybe even like last patch. You don't actually see that much Quap or Tusk anymore. Tusk kind of got nerfed pretty hard, but people still pick him from time to time. Here's the thing. So I should point this out, that the first game was on US East. The second game was on Lux, I believe. And now this game is also on US East. Let me check my ping. The answer to that question is yes, it is on US East. So that's pretty interesting. That's very important to note. So each team won on their own home server. So we'll wait and see if that's going to continue to be the case for Complexity.
Yeah, luckily, not like in Dota 1 where Europe to America was about a 3-second delay. Now you maybe a 0.5. I mean, it's not as big as it used to be, but it's definitely still.
Yeah, and it's going to continue to still be there until we somehow get better internet, or I guess the internet as it is now is going to go. I don't think it's ever really going to change. I hope it does, but sadly, ping issues will always stay and always arise and see to be that way. However, we'll see how it plays out.
Marty, Tidehunter. We've seen Tidehunter more in the last week than we have in like 2 years now.
Yeah. And it's not really worked out from what I've seen anyway. There's like been one or two teams that have picked it. I think I saw Shazam pick it. They got crushed with it. I saw DC pick it. They got crushed with it. So
I think Stake picked it as well, and they got they got beat. Yeah, it's not had a good run.
No. So this hero continues to get picked despite a negative win rate. Well, maybe not negative, but a poor win rate going his way. They'll pick up the Timbersaw for Complexity game, which is pretty damn good against Tide. With your Whirling Death, obviously, it's pretty nice, the Strength Steal, but there are a lot of good heroes in this pool, and I'm surprised they picked the ones that I picked. Not necessarily surprised about AA, but about really every other hero. You know, I think, okay, Morphling is very good. It's a very solid hero. It's good picks all the time. Terrorblade's pretty good. TA is very strong. Razor's very strong. Maybe even Omni and Lush, but not the heroes that I've seen so far.
There's been TA's been in every single pool, and it has not been banned or picked once, surprisingly.
Yeah, it's a very good hero, but it's not particularly great against Quap mid. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not that great because of Shadow Strike still. They've already picked the Wind Ranger for what I imagine to be a Weeha Wind Ranger who absolutely loves this hero. I mean, we saw what he could do with just a tiny mid lane, and he got a freaking double rampage last game, but we'll see if he's going to be playing this Wind Ranger. And also, Pycat was playing Wind Ranger too, I should point out. It's a very good Pycat hero too, so.
Yeah, I'm hoping for the Weeha. Weeha's Wind Rangers reminds me of like Koroks and Dendies in like the TI3 era. Mm-hmm. They were the ones going for like phase boots into straight blink, nothing else, and kind of plays like that, and it's enjoyable. Enjoyable Wind Ranger to watch.
Maybe not the Slashers build where you just go phase Aghanims until your next. And you need like two items to actually damage when you get Aghanims, except you need like an Aghanim and like a crit or something.
Yeah, and Mama's Boy is just straight up. They have a lot of teammates. A lot.
Is this a support Phoenix, is the question, because they already have a Tidehunter, or vice versa, I suppose.
I'm going to guess Tidehunter support is my best. Yeah, I mean,
because he can jungle, I suppose.
Been known to be wrong, but not often, you know. Be a support Tidehunter, Iron Talon, jungle kind of thing, like the Treant they did first game.
Right, exactly. And Phoenix can't really get away with that. She's not great with Iron Talon or just jungling in general. You actually need bubbles, and poor Phoenix is okay. I will wait and see. We'll see if you're correct, but they do pick up the Morphling with their last pick, as I talked about. Very good hero in this patch. It's going to be very hard to take down if you're Complexity. I think you need to get an Orca for Quap, probably, or you have to have enough damage to blow him up.
Yeah, and there's a read to see another 5th Ick Leshrac from Complexity Gaming. They could do with another support and throw Omni into the off lane and have Timber in the safe lane. Yeah, maybe right. They will.
We'll see. They have that tough support. Chessie's going to be playing the Quap. Now the question is, who's playing the Timber? It looks like it will be Swindle, as Zephyr's picked down.
So Swindle, the carry Leshrac.
Yeah, I'm down with that. I've seen him play it before. He's done a good job, so.
And Phoenix will be off lane, since we've seen Mass carry all three games playing that off lane, or, I mean, safe lane, but.
It's an interesting draft, man. I'm pretty excited about this draft, actually. I don't know how you feel about it.
Me too. That first, the first AA level 6 and Tide level 6, that's going to be a huge fight for them. They can't afford to, like, waste those. And with the Tide Hunter, more of the threat of your ultimate against the other team than your actual ultimate selves. Like, they always have to be on their toes. After you use and you win a team fight, then, I mean, you can't really team fight until next one comes up. So we'll see how they play around it.
Yeah, it does come to that Ravage, I think, and you're absolutely right. And we'll wait and see how effective it's going to be with the rest of the team fighting. I mean, they have a lot of team fights too. Ravage, like you talked about, AA ultimate, waveform, everything from Pycat, Yapsors, Supernova. So there's a lot of different abilities here that you have to fight around if you're Complexity. And Complexity is more sustained damage than anything, right? You look at it, and all of their ultimates, with the exception of like Z-Freak, are pretty sustainable. And I guess for the Quap as well. So it's more of a sustained team fight versus big team fight.
Seems like a lot of these games, like last game, Z-Freak put in a lot of work. Like that top fight, when they did get Rampage, he can live so long. And with the Omni Knight, he's going to have the repels on point, especially against that Ravage.
Yeah.
Repels only a Timber Saw and just go ham.
Oh, God. Timber Saw being repelled seems quite frightening. on top of the fact, if you get a heal bomb before you pop that repel onto somebody, that's going to be pretty frightening as well. So they have some good survivability. They have the AoE disruption and the snowball if they can get a blink dagger up for Hanskin early on or. Oh,
they,
neck or something.
Sorry, I just noticed they swapped heroes. So it is Tide in the offlane. Mass carry now on the Tide Hunter. They swapped during the pause with an Iron Talon.
Phoenix support. Phoenix support for him. So it's like, okay, what's happening? But yeah, you're right. Mass Greed does have the Iron Talon. He also picks up the set of Tangos as well. We'll see if he goes for early, like, Anchor Smash and, like, Crack and shit all in the stack of the Ancients. We'll wait to see if that's going to be the case. Limp, meanwhile, has 8 Tangos. Look for the top rune spot, but it is going to be contested by 3 heroes, actually 4 heroes from my Art Mamas, aka the Mamas Boys, and Chessie will pick up that bottom tier, or bottom dining rune.
And both mids, of course, going for the Null, one going for double Fairy Fire, one going for the branch Fairy Fire. Fairy Fires, man, I still love that item. It's like the best item they've put in the game in like 5 years.
I remember when it came out, I was one of the haters as well. I did not like that item. I just thought, I'm like, why? And now I realize the power that it's had, so.
I think because it makes the early game, like, a little more aggressive. People can dive, heal up, like, Lotus Orbs and Glimmer Capes are all fun and stuff, but the simplest item, better game.
Yeah, I agree with you. The idea that you could just run up and try to man fight somebody early on because of a fairy fire is great stuff, so we'll wait and see if that's going to be effective. Limp versus the Tidehunter top lane, and Limp will go for the early reactive armor, which is not really conducive to him zoning out or last hitting against the Tidehunter, but this is going to be an aggro tri-lane versus defensive tri-lane, and it might be a good one at that. There's a lot of defensive prowess coming out from Complexity side, but there's a lot of damage coming out from Soxie, Yapzor, and Pycat as well. They have to be very careful with how they play this for both squads, and there's a good ward here too, getting vision for Mama's Boys on top of that.
Yeah, and I think they might, Hanskin might know they have that, because he just got hit while he's in the jungle and the creeps didn't see him. I mean, that would be a lucky guess seeing that, but we'll see.
Yeah, I don't think I saw a ping, he might have, I didn't quite see it. But
yeah, it's all about if Hanskin traps one in, Swindle gets that stun off with the heal bomb, it's gonna be a good game. I don't really think Mama's Boy can initiate, per se. They definitely can't.
Yeah, Complexity, everyone's running at them anyways. They get the pull off. They actually see it because, oh, it got dewarded. The ward behind the camp got dewarded. Nicely done for Mama's Boys. There was one there for Complexity. Now they have no vision down this bottom lane. Hanskin's in some trouble. There's going to be the cold feet, chilling touch coming out. No cold feet just yet. There's going to be the heal bomb coming out. Hanskin is about to fall. First blood will go their way as Pycat gets him with the waveform. And now Complexity have to back away. There's the cold feet coming out in Swindle. He won't be able to get lashed up with it. He's going to turn around for a moment and thought about stunning. Z-Freak will get out. And the Fire Spirit doing a lot of damage, but he'll salve up and Swindle will have a couple of tangos as well, and they actually do get the rotation back from Hanskin. So he just didn't have Stone Blood. He couldn't really dodge a lot of that damage.
Yeah, and Swindle missed that stun on him. He canceled the stun once after the Ice Shards. Maybe he thought a fake out was coming, and do have the AA Chilling Touch. That's so much damage.
It's not like they're doing great in last hits either. You look at it, iCat has currently 7, and Swindle will get some room to work with here, but they might just need to think about rotating Hero 2 back to that, you know, another lane. I'm not sure.
It's gonna be hard to get kills on either teams. No one can, they don't really have a lockdown for Quap, and Complexity doesn't really have a lockdown for a win run for Windranger.
Yeah. Speaking of that, that matchup, how it's like going mid lane, you can see right now, there's 8 lasts for Weeha. Bottom. There's gonna be a breakout of a fight here. Look at that ice shards, beautifully done. Swindle is pretty low. There's gonna be the Icarus dive back forward as well. Wait for him, they'll grab the kill on Swindle. Soxa will fall, but Hanskin doesn't have Snowball for 8. He's in trouble. Z-Freak doesn't have the mana to heal him up. And Yapzor will pick up a double kill. He's gonna chase down by Dejanora, but Z-Freak might actually fall. He has to buy his boots up as well. He just doesn't have the mana to heal. If he did, he'd be able to just take this fight easily. Unfortunately, it's not the case.
Waveform in 2 seconds.
Yeah, he's got mana enough for Waveform here in just a moment here. And there's gonna be the Waveform in the last right click for Pike. Will secure the kill. And that is all. All 3 of those heroes dead for Collective. They need to break up the try lane. I don't see them if sending all those heroes back to that bottom lane.
Yeah, Yopsor's slow. Like, all they have after their initial 3 spells are cast on Complexity is their auto attacks, and you're against a Phoenix who's hitting fire spirits on all 3 of you every single time. They're doing nothing.
It's been a pretty impressive display of power coming out from Yopsor. He's done a great job. And it's just gonna be Swindle down here for right now. It looks like Hanskin might rotate back in, but you can see the Omni is heading towards that top lane. Z-Freak is like, I just want to pull and get experience and maybe like roam on mid, even though I'm not a great roamer, but just give me something, because right now I've got nothing. It's not been a great start for Complexity.
I think Limp at level 6, if he does heal or do something, I think he can solo kill his Tidehunter pretty well, but Tidehunter just now bought a bottle, he'll be bringing it out.
Limp does have a Mango plus Wand charges if he wants to try to go for a kill, but he's not quite at level 6 yet. He's close. He needs maybe another creep wave here. Z-Freak will allow him to get to that level 6 by pulling. And then maybe change.
Bottom lane,
well.
Yopsor chasing Swindle. Edict
up the Edicts. And Yopsor can't walk up and try to man fight. Maybe he can now with Soxic in the tree. He's got Splitter. There's the Cult Feet. The Icarus Dodge comes out as well. He'll pop the Fairy Fire only to die to the Fire Spirit soon thereafter, almost getting into Snowball. Yapzor will still fall to the Snowball, but since they left Swindle, now Sax is going to get jumped on. Shadow Strike will fly through. No Roar's Punch for Hanskin. He's only level 3. So they'll trade a 1-for-1 engagement. That's not going to be really favorite Complexity, as they got a support Phoenix for their offlane Swindle with Leshrac.
And Swindle's having a roof. Luckily, he's such a low level, all these. He just TP back in and get all the experience. Pycat, level 5 treads, Aquila, and about 200 gold. He's having a good one bottom.
Yeah, he'll probably work on getting out like in Sphere later on down the road. Pretty nice. Maybe not. There's not. But there's going to be an action happening. Ice Shards. Weeha's going to go for the win run. Looking for Chesty. Sonic Wave will fly. Pops the Fairy Fire. Stays alive. Weeha's going to try to bottle through his damage. He will still fall in the end, but a better trade top now. A fight breaking out. Masquerade. He's going to get off. He's going to be able to get away for the time being, but the Whirling Death after the Timber Chain coming through and will be yet another kill for Complexity at the very least. But still, they're not getting the better end of these trades with the exception of that kill in the top lane.
Yeah, and Queen of Painhead. Both her Fairy Fires up that entire time. Bia was the only one who popped his and got the kill.
Yeah, maybe you forgot. Swindle is gonna get caught. There's the Cold Feet plus the jumping from the Icarus dive will be enough to get the kill on the waveform will be the last hit. Pycat, who now has, as you mentioned, an Aquila and Treads, and maybe even almost Wand here. All of the early game items close to being completed. Pretty damn devastating if you're Mama's Boys. That's so tough to deal with at this point.
This is looking really good for Mama's Boy, this Morphling already level 6 at 6 minutes in. That's been like a full tri lane almost.
Yeah.
Lane, we're gonna see a Yopsor knows the runes taking pink it out.
Top lane, they're trying to converge on a monster, but he does get the pull up. And he's also got a great ward that's been here since the beginning of the game. He's about to finally fall. And Moskery is up to Boots Bottle, as you talked about. Might go for our Arcanes. More than likely, he could just go blink. And will he be the one getting that? Maybe Yopsor's the one to pick it up. He does have his Urn of Shadows. There's gonna be the Shaft Sonic Chesty, beautifully done, but he blinks away. There's no way they can really catch him. The focus part, rather, the Power Shot will not grab the kill. Meanwhile, top Moskery is gonna get caught. There's gonna be the Repel coming through. Rolling Depths up in 2. They've got the Timber Chain. He's gonna cancel. He's got Chakram in 1. So it was a little bit further behind the tower that he wanted, so he's gonna try to keep you up. There's the Ravage coming in. Limp has made a huge mistake as the Sunray will fall. The Chakram will only go for a moment after he's died. Down bottom, Soxa getting caught out. Rather, it's Pycat doing the catching out. They're gonna find Suna looking for Hanskin as well. They've got Waveform up. But Hanskin is a little bit too tanky. He's got too much HP for them to grab this kill. And two kills going away, Mama's Boys. Now Chessy will jump in. They get the kill off Pike. That a much needed one as Chessy comes through the screen, pain and blink. And Zox will get zoned out. They won't find that kill, but Chessy finally gets a pickup here for his team.
And there are the mana boots untied. Yeah, Chessy, that rotation was super needed. Pycat dying in and picking up the kill. Chessy really needed that because he is a little bit behind.
And look at the net worth. It's 1,500, almost 2,000 in favor of Mama's Boys. You can see it in a net worth chart. The only one even close to the rest of the squad of Mama's Boys is Chessy on Flexity side. You look at Swindles, he's third to last in net worth. Z-Freak is last. And then the Tusk is right below the Timbersaw, which is not particularly great, but you know, it could be worse, I suppose.
Yeah, this last try, Swindle, this is the roughest I've seen him have it in a long time.
I take any chase down, so I have to shrink more. If the ice shards will come through, it'll only clip him and do some damage in that regard, but not any blockage, so.
They're buying Swindle room now. He's actually level 6, so he'd be a lot of room top just in that last minute.
And it's not like he doesn't do that much damage when he is like level 4 edict and like Pulse Nova. Like, if they can take a team fight that is prolonged and avoid a Ravage, I'm sure they can actually win, or at least kill a couple of people for Mama's Boys. Maybe not win the fight outright, but I don't know. It's tough.
TP bottom, we might see bottom by Ops, or we might see initiation from them.
2 versus 3 down this bottom lane. Limp and Hanskin trying to get some vision. They see Pike hit in the jungle. They might have seen the App Store. They're going to try to go for the Ice Shard. Sox will be able to just avoid that by getting last hits. There's going to be the Ice Vortex. Hanskin's going to get chased down. Pike is his waveform. They have no really way to catch Hanskin out, though. So they'll be able to walk away, so the initiation is not quite there for Mama's Boys.
Let's settle down a little bit after the 14 kills in 8 minutes.
Wow, that is a lot, actually, in your ward. Yeah. It's a decent amount.
Yeah, I think putting Timber bottom, big difference with level 3 Timber Chain. He can get away a lot easier than a Leshrac can.
So if you go back and you look at the early start of this game, would you suggest that maybe he just goes down there in the first place, or?
I think getting him, he needed the level. I think he would have died just a bunch if he didn't have the levels he has now.
Okay.
I think they just played the lane wrong bottom, and Mama's Boy played it perfectly, just letting Cole go onto them and played the long con on him.
Yeah. Well, this will provide at least some more room for Swindle, as you talked about top lane. He's putting some pressure on that tier 1 tower, which will inevitably forward it up, which they already did, and they can TP in as well. With two of their heroes. Excuse me, they're gonna send an ice blast up to the top lane. Twiddle will try to take the tower down, he'll get it done, but he might get caught because of it. Jack Chat will fly long range, but won't be able to connect and last time to the tree line. We all will continue to chase him. He's got wind run, he's got focus fire, and he's got a double damage room. But here comes Hans, gets the snowball in as well. Swindle's gonna get caught, but there's the Loris Punch. They get the splitters off, they get the kill, and Swindle will stay alive with 30 HP in the tank. Now lift down bottom lane, there's the Icarus side to Cold Pizza, though, the waveform, and that is a kill going their way. All right, a pretty big kill for both squads when it's all said and done.
Yeah, but Swindle gets the kill and the tower, and that's the turnaround he needed.
Yeah. 1,200 gold plus level 8 now, Grant. He's up to halfway and about now. Actually, a little bit behind Weehan. Weehan's now struggling after that initial, I guess, okay laning phase.
Oh, have bottom lane. Pikehead will just get it.
They have Sentry here. Oh, they see Chessy. They notice that he's here. Chessy P blinks in, he can maybe get this kill, but Pike can try to avoid it. He's got the replicate. Oh, he's gonna go for the replicate. He knows that Chessy's behind him.
That Phoenix is looking funky. The replicate.
Yeah, it is sort of on fire, but not really.
Go Bronco.
Oh no.
Got him.
Oh dear. I'm sorry, Chessy, that's gotta feel not great. Really great bait, though, and a good sentry ward placement, honestly, coming up from Mama's Boys.
Yeah, Mama's Boys just playing a tad bit better right now, and that's the difference.
Just dunked on him right there, the bait from the good old replicate. And this will give some room for Moskri top lane. Looks like he's going to be heading towards that blink tag.
Oh, good start by Swindle.
Now bottom, they're going to pick up the kill. The split earth comes out, the ice blast coming through. Will actually not even hit with the debuff. Oh, it does hit with the debuff, but not actually connect to the actual damage. Well, Chessy in trouble, but here's going to be the rotation from Hanskin. They're going to pick the kill on the Windranger and Pycat. Now in trouble, here comes the Ravage, hitting on 2. Now they're going to use the Scream of Pain as well. Pycat in trouble. They don't have the Sonic Wave. Hanskin has to back away. Chessy slowed up. Oh, look at that freaking Frozen Sigil helping out for them trying to get away. And Moskru with the Gush is not able to do enough damage there, and they actually lose a 1-for-1 in the process, I believe.
That is not bad for Complexity again. They get Swindle, get the bottom tower, and they only lose the Timber. while Weah goes down. So Swindle's happy. He's like, man, I'm glad no one's going for me anymore. I'm just getting free towers, free everything.
Yeah, level 8 still, but now up to 1600 gold. Next item. Oh, hold that thought. Mid lane is going to be a catch-up potentially. Snowball comes through. Yapzor is going to be in trouble. There's the Scream of Pain. Gets off the Supernova. The Purification will come out. They're going to try to back away from this. They don't want to get sent up. There's going to be the Power Shot. They're out of range now of the AoE from Supernova, and they will be able to back away. So that's down, plus no Ravage. But we'll see if Complexity can defend this without a lot of their own abilities and a lot of the sustain they need.
And Mac on Tide coming out on the checkout.
Which is huge. I thought he was going to go blink, but that's not the case. Focus Fire. Pycat's putting some pressure here on this Tier 1 tower as well as he's gone back and gotten some health. And then replicated back in. And it looks like this Tier 1 tower will fall. Whether or not they can deny it, it remains to be seen. Well, he instead goes for the Shadow Strike, and Pycat has to wait for more than now. Strength more as well. While that was happening, Limp was putting pressure on the Tier 2 tower top lane. He's up to 2300 gold, so... Ooh, a Veil. Damn. I like it.
A blink on the Timber Saw there. They're going, they want to take team down the next, like, 5-8 minutes. Pretty much going in on the early game here.
Yeah. Blink for the Timber, they're ready to go. Ravage is down for 45 seconds. If they want to get into a team fight, now would be the most optimal time to do so. They have a smoke potentially on the courier. They have one on Hansky. They're going to back up, and I think they're going to use it here. With four heroes in the vicinity, Swindle will get caught with it too. Meanwhile, this is going to leave Chessie farming mid lane. They could use him, but he could blink in. He's going to be going for the Orchid, as I talked about earlier, with that Oblivion staff, and they're going to head bottom for Soxa. He's not the best target to pick up, but I mean, it kills a kill unless they roam on mid and go behind a tower and try to find Yapzor or something. It's going to be the case, actually.
Yeah, look at Teal already TP'd out this. I mean, Teal pinged out the smoke. They don't know they're there, but it's a reasonable guess.
Yeah, maybe an obvious smoke coming in, but. Looks like the Blitz here aren't going to find anything off the back end of this. Swindle will actually push, so they know that this is happening now.
Oh, yeah.
So on the Swindle, he's going to get caught. He's actually going to have to back away. He's taking a lot of damage. Sunray was going to go. He's actually going to be shadowed in this. Now they're going to fight, though. Here comes the Will and Guess, but they get off a great speed. The Sagwa comes in, and Weehaw might fall, but they get the Ravage off the one. Z-Freak is going to be in trouble. No purification available. Yapzor gets a double kill because of a Supernova. Great fight. Now Lip's gonna have to Timber Chain away, but will not get far. The Shockwave will fly. He's about to fall. He does have 6 charges. He'll be able to Timber Chain away, but they earn charge and Sunray coming out. And Yapzor gets a triple kill. Now Shackle Shot will fly and alive beautifully into Hanska. They get off the ice shards around the ice vortex. He got Power Shot as well. Here comes the ice blast coming in. Chessie's about to shatter. Hanska will go down. They get the kill to Weehaw, but it is a 1-for-5 trade, or about to be, as Hanska. Well, he might actually make it out alive. If the Urn Shard comes out, but here's going to be the rotation coming through from Masker. He actually can't fight him. He's juked his way further into the jungle. He'll be able to TP out. He will survive, but it is still a 4-for-1 trade. And Mama's Boy gets a huge advantage after that fight.
That was a perfect AA ult on the Quap and the Leshrag, and then Yopsor could just fly in, throw all that damage out, and Swindle had no chance of living. I mean, heal doesn't do much versus AA's ult.
Yeah. Was Pycat even there, man?
I don't believe he was, no.
Wow.
He's just farming it up.
He has.
He's got that link in about 1k.
Yeah, he's very farmed. Went about to get caught by Yapzor, but he's able to Timber Chain away just fine. Speaking of Veil, another one is picked up for Yapzor. So you Veil on each side, which is pretty uncommon this early on in the game. I think that's a good item, and I wish more people would buy it, but they seem to have listened.
Knew they're like, Matt would appreciate this. Yeah. Veil on each side. We barely see a Veil on one side.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, Yopsar could be in trouble. Nope, they don't go.
Now Limp's down bottom with Blink Dagger. They could try to go on to Mastery, but he's a hard target to bring down, especially with the mech. So go back away. And Weehaw kinda had a rough start. He's up to a point booster now. That's it. So it's not a really great start for him still. He's like below halfway net worth. He's below Swindles now at this point.
Yep, these item choices make all the difference. It, see, the Blink Dagger on Limp's not doing much because they haven't, like, run around the map and ganged much. He's just been farming neutrals, so they still want that mid tower, but
well,
they're not going to overcommit.
I think it's hard to. First of all, they can't find Pycat. Secondly, even if they did, he could just replicate out. And they are playing very passive, I think, for Mama's Boys. They're not really getting caught on the wrong side of the map, so. And this just allows Pycat to farm even faster, and when he gets that Lincoln Sphere, he might want to fight, he might want to wait for his next item, like the Hero Blade more than likely, or Mantis Tile or something, but we'll wait and see if that's actually the case. We might just go Mantis because there is going to be an Orchid up here for Chessie pretty soon, but maybe I'll win there. They're going to get the Shackle Shot on Z-Freak. He's got Purification, he'll get it off just in time. Now he gets the Repel off as well, and they won't be able to secure this kill. Hanskin and Limper looking to go from the back up. The Yapster seems to know this, as they have a ward on the other side of the river. So that's only going to be more time wasted if they're pushing top lane, and Squid will have to rotate up and go ahead and clear this out.
Chessie about 500 away from his Orchid though, and that'll be he could start getting picked off some Pycat by himself. He'd have Pycat's sitting on a lot of HP though with that Lincoln. He's like, yeah, I'm not getting picked off.
Yeah, that's the Shadow Strike Lincoln or Shadow Strike and Orchid right after. That's just not gonna work. Swindle's gonna get caught with the Ice Blast. We'll do some damage, but not nearly enough to bring him down. However, they're looking to jump in with Masquerade and Pycat. That's not gonna be the case. The Blink is done for Masquerade, but he doesn't have it yet. It's on the courier currently, or about to be rather. So what will happen is that Complexity will split push. We have, we'll rotate down to the bottom lane, power shot, and clear out the creep if it's possible. So there's just a lot of split farming again, split pushing. We have, will get hit up with the ice shards. They'll be able to back away.
You see a little more careful play. I mean, both teams, all it takes is one point and they're in.
It's a very tight game so far. Mama's boys have that 4,000 net worth advantage, which is not much, all things considered, but wait and see. There's the Orchid now done for the co-op.
Blink done for the Tide. He's actually mech, blink, arcane boots. He's good.
Yeah, he's very farmed. He's second in net worth, actually, which is pretty damn impressive for an offlane Tide Hunter. Ice Blast sailing top lane. It's not going to hand on the Swindle. If he walks in, it might, but... Lane. Jesse walks underneath a sentry ward, and the Shackle Shot will come out. Focus fire, and Jesse is done to a gut from Masquerade. He just walks in, unfortunately. To a Linking Spear, or rather not to God, to a Sentry Ward he was not expecting. I don't know why it's linked so strange, but still. Nonetheless, Pycat
on top lane now. Pycat's taking a lot of damage.
Yeah, he's taking a lot of damage, but he's going to be able to get his Strength Morph and go to work. And he's got now up to 1,000 HP just from Strength Morph. Good God. Can't kill him, man. They just can't do it.
Even with that Whirling Blade, they were close. He was at about 200 HP, but... that he's just...
Yeah. Gonna be the biggest issue, I think, this game is killing Pycat.
Yeah,
not possible, but
just a good Whirling Death and a good Orc buff, and they could take him, and that means you're lead.
Bucks needed to find some extra farm for themselves, even their most net worth hero is
gets veiled up.
The Sunray actually does so much damage, he's gonna die to an Ice Blast. Oh, he just misses it. The Urn Charge will take him down. The Snowball will avoid it. Capture is going to go ahead and pop the Supernova to get the kill. Nifty play, but this will allow Swindle and Complexity to get in a better position. Swindle, however, has to hit a stun. Icarus Dive. He's trying to make sure he gets it off the time. Here's the Repel. The Veil will come out. The Lightning Storm coming through, but not enough. The Absor is going to be able to get away. Meanwhile, Shack Shovel fly to Z-Freak, but Weehaw's caught in a bad position now as the Pulstone and Edict are going through. Windrun's about to end. You just can't quite chase him down. The Lightning Storm is up and ready to go. Meanwhile, Yapzor still looking to go to work. Chessie was caught in the backside. Meanwhile, still the Rapids used by Masquerade in the river. They will find Weehaw in the end. He actually will stay alive for now. Wow, this is impressive. He's juking and jobbing. Yapzor is low. The Sunray not doing enough to get a kill. We will finally go down to Limp and the Whirling Death. The Ice Blast will come in. That'll be that. They do end up getting that other kill onto Yapzor. It's a dominating screen picked up for Swindle. It's the strangest fight I've ever seen.
Yeah, and Lightner literally just got a solo kill in the river.
Yeah.
On it. Well, that's interesting. Black City does get a few kills. Yeah, Ravage for Claws, that's great.
The most net worth here on Complexity's side, I completely agree with the side. Getting that kill's pretty damn big. Okay, now his Guardian Greed is supposed to blink. Your ward. No.
Just cheaping back home.
Yeah. Oh, are they gonna find Pycat here? Lincoln Sphere's been popped. They have Orchid. And I think he used it to break that Lincoln Sphere. Yeah, he did. Something, I don't know what happened.
They just don't have the... After he used that initial punch from the Tusk, they just don't have any shutdown on him.
Yeah,
that's... Snowball.
I mean, they can't kill him. And Pycat has yet to die this game, I believe. He's died once, actually. He's got 10,000 net worth. GPM of 475. He continues to farm up. Shackle Shot will go into a creep, almost hitting on a Z-Freak. Not so lucky though. Ice Blast is going to come in. It'll hit on the Z-Freak, it looks like. And that'll be the case. The Icarus Dive comes through and pop up the Repel to try to stay alive and not take that damage coming in from the Frostbite of the Ice Blast. Back away.
Yeah, I think Complexity is playing it right now. They just need to get a few items. Like that fight bottom, they just hide around a little bit. In the end, they took down multiple people. Now Weeyah's in a lot of trouble mid.
Yeah, he's body gonna get caught, blocked, but fine, actually, because they've got the artillery coming up from the Absolute with the Sunray. Top lane, Hanskin, wave for Piecat gets a solo kill. And now looking for the second one as Chessie is in the tree line. Masquerade doesn't have Ravage, but with a Blink Dagger, he can chase out and look for that kill. But Chessie's able to TP back to home. And Piecat continues to farm, now getting the Yasha for the inevitable Mantis style pickup, as I talked about earlier, to avoid that Orphan level in silence. A huge pickup.
Yeah, the only saving grace for Cold, Pell's gonna be so big late game versus A Blast and Ravage. And Leshrac almost has his Octarine or Bloodstone. Not really sure which one he wants to go here.
Probably, I imagine Bloodstone first, but I don't know. Limp's gonna jump into the Soxa down bottom. The Cold Feet's about to fly. They get off the Lightning Storm. Splinter is not there to grab the kill, and Limp is actually in a lot of trouble. They've all rotated in. Masquerade will find the Gush and Anchor Smash to provide himself the kill. Easily done. And Mama's Boys, they get dope bottom lane, and they respond appropriately.
Yeah, and AA still going for that late. You'll see all AA's going for Midas. So about 300 off for that 25 minute. Just get the levels he needs. Piecat split pushes.
He stopped off at the Bracer earlier, and had he not stopped off for that, he might have either A, died a lot further, or B, actually had the Midas this time, but it doesn't really matter either way. He's very close to it now. Luke will come out. Hanskin will be able to die out of this tier 2 tower top lane, but Piecat is... I feel like he's almost playing this like a Broodmother. He's always top. I've not seen him not top except for the beginning of this game. He split pushed effectively enough to grab a tier 2 tower out of it.
And once he gets that level 3 ult, he can just make an image anytime, be in a fight within the next minute. Playing him real well.
Yeah. And Void Stone pick for the Tidehunter. Is this one likely? It's going to be
Refresher,
right?
Yeah. And he has a gem.
Yeah, it's huge. He's going to take an Aegis stack from too.
Yeah, the highest level in the game, jeez.
And I think he's just a little bit under the Morphling in terms of net worth. Somehow this game is still 5,000 net worth in favor of Mama's Boys. It feels like it should be more, but Swindle's gonna get caught, I think, here in this bottom lane. This is the Cold Feet. Ice Blast. Icarus Dive didn't really connect. He's gonna go ahead and CP away, and he'll make it out in time. A little bit more dangerous than I thought it would be, but the Cold Feet didn't latch enough. I think they need to save the Cold Feet to stop.
Yeah, just chase him around. I'm still just farming. Looks like he's probably gonna go for a Yules. It could be a Aghanim's, but...
Yeah, especially this early when you don't have a lot of mana. I think it's gonna be Yules.
Weeyah does have his eggs a little bit, but he's got it, and that's what matters. That's a lot of damage.
Yeah,
we haven't really seen a big team fight, sorry, from like Tide or AA. Just hasn't really been one. I think that's good for Cole, but yeah, they don't. Somehow Mama's Boys find like solo kills on Quap's stuff up top line.
Masquerade has a Invis Rune plus Ravage at the ready, and this is going to be a double man, oh, 2-man Ravage, or it would be until he got the Repel off. Now, Piecat's going to get caught with a Chakram. He's actually going to have to wait for Boys. The one death came through. A lot of damage. Repel is about to wear off. They have Ravage at the ready, and Repel is done right now. There's going to be the Ravage coming out. Repel is about to go, but now Limp is destroyed by Masquerade's Gush as well as the right click from Piecat, the waveform, and that's a double kill coming from Masquerade's Tidehunter, and now it's even more room for Mama's Boys to work with.
After last game, he's like, nah, that's not my full pitch. I'll show you how to play a harder offlaner and play it perfectly. And his Tidehunter, that was a perfect time to Ravage. Omni, 0.1 second, he just casts ult, closed him up.
Like, waits right for that Repel to come out, and that's huge. I mean,
there's the Manta.
Pick up the gem for the Z-Freak. Omni Knight, meanwhile, Chessie almost got shackled and brought down. Weeyah with the right click is doing a lot of damage. Here's going to be the Walrus Punch, Sonic Wave, and this should be a dead Weeyah. The Cold Feet will come out, the Chilling Touch as well. They'll pick up Chessie, that's the gem on the deck. That's Weeyah's gem, but they'll grab it and they'll get a double kill for Yapsa with the Sunray. This is so much damage Yaps was actually owning. And meanwhile, back at the base, Piecat's taking a tier 3 tower. They'll get up a couple of heroes, they're going to TP in. Piecat can just go ahead and wave him away at this point. He's also got his Lincoln Spear, so they can't take him down. But still, the tier 3 tower is gone, Grant, this top tier 3 area.
Yeah, this is how they should have played that first game. Now they're playing a third game perfectly. Yeah. Finding the pickoffs and... Middle lane, Swindle's in a lot of trouble.
There's gonna be the Lightning Storm, and he's gonna get caught with the Ice Shard, or rather the Ice Blast, and the Cold Feet. Swindle's gonna get caught, and gets destroyed, actually. I think he has a Bloodstone, too, and he just lost three freaking charges to his Bloodstone, and he just picked that up, too. Oh, God.
Yeah, Tide's only about 2k off his Refresher. Mm-hmm. I think at that point, they might try to just 5v5.
Can they roast yet? I think they can. Let's see if they want to. Looks like that's not gonna happen, but they have the Ags for the win rage as we've talked about. Firecat's very farm with his Mantis style and inevitably getting a Ethereal Blade probably afterwards. Picks up his Ghost Scepter next. Wait and see.
See, it's either gonna be a Scotty or an Athblade.
Light breaking out. Obfuscate Shackle Shot won't last. Firecat going to work with the Force Replicate back in. They're gonna go ahead and snowball. There's gonna be a great Supernova, but they'll actually get zoned out. Ice Flash will not connect. And it's gonna be a gap to strike to pick up the first kill. They're looking for Chessy, but he can blink out now. The Shadow Strike will go. He'll be able to blink away. The Power Shot's not there to grab the kill. Piecat's kind of screwed up, but still, they're gonna jump in Mastery. Skyrapid for 7 seconds. Doesn't have the mana for it now, with Guardian Griefs coming out. Chessy, a gap to strike. Great deal, but the waveform comes through. It's not enough damage to bring it down, but with the Absor, it is, as he gets off the Fire Spirit. They've got Ravage ready to go. The Repel will fly, but not nearly in time. It's Swindle. They'll fall as they lose 4 heroes to Complexity side. The last one is going to be Limp, and it's going to be a 5-man wipe. All 5 will go down on Complexity side, and now Mama's Boys has this game in the palm of their hand as they'll transition this maybe into Roche, maybe into a Tier 2 tower, maybe into both. They get a great team fight going away.
Just a perfect team fight from him, even though that Omni's ult was really good, but Tide's ult wasn't even up, and right when it came up, he just blasted and hit off the last 3 remaining people.
Riven Ravage was absolutely crucial for that fight, and Piecat just did so much damage. Morphling is back, baby. That hero, pretty good.
They have not had one bad Ravage. It's hard to say that in a game, and they really haven't had one bad one.
Yeah. Askari has, I think, transitioned from the poor game he had in game number 2 and even game number 1 where he didn't have the greatest game to this third game, which has been absolutely beautifully done from him. The Tidehunter is the second in net worth. He's the highest level in the game, I believe, still. He's actually tied with the Morphling. How many last hits does he have? 125. This is all with not that much farm, actually, when you think about it in terms of last hits. And he's got average refresher here and, you know, about 1,000 gold. Pretty damn impressive.
Yeah, we haven't seen Chessy really do much in this mid-ish going into the late game after those early bottom looking for farm and they're not finding it.
Now that's really the story of this game. They couldn't find farm bottom, they couldn't get kills bottom. They found a little bit of farm top and mid for them in the early stages of this game, but since
middle lane.
Yeah, there's gonna be the Ice Boss coming through. Weehaw's gonna look for the Shackle. Focus Fire will not be able to bring him down. It'll take a lot of damage. Power Shot almost clipped in him, and if it did, it would have been the kill probably from the Shatter, but that's not the case. He'll be able to back up, bottle up, and regen back in the well.
And if AA goes, I assume he's going to go Aghanim's. That would have been a kill, yeah, too.
Strike, top lane. Can't wait for him in. There's the great purification. Now, Bycat's going to have to regen up using his strength more. He'll try to break his limp down. Chakram will go limp. He's realized he stayed too long. He misses the Timber Chain. He actually might die to a waveform here. He's going to replicate in. One more right click will do the job. Wait for him to catch him out. And now, Soxin, Colby will actually get the kill with his right click. That's a huge kill. And just casually, they pick it up. Meanwhile, back towards Van Hanskins, he's going to get caught. Weehaw's low. The Summoner will keep him alive, though. Now the Ice Shards will take him down. Great new from Hanskin. And now Yapsor is going to have to do this on his own. The Supernova will fly. They're going to try to right click it down. He is rather blue tanky with the Force level 2 or 3, I believe. They're going to get the kill, though, with Swindle. Just right clicking it down. Meanwhile, though, Chessy will fall to Soxa. And it's really just Chessy, or rather, Swindle alone now. He's gonna get a Splitter Thump as well as the Lightning Storm Edict and Cold Stone, but he gets himself a double kill. Back up to 6 stacks. Actually, he gets a mega kill spree from the Lush, or from the Ancient Apparition, getting up to 3,700 gold. They're roaming in, they've got Z-Freak and Swindle nearby, but here comes Pike getting the Adaptive Strike. Setting up, there's the Ravage, just on a Z-Freak, set Jay's Lapel. Has gone through, the waveform will fly. That's gonna be the Gem of True Sight dropped from the deck. They'll grab that, they'll back away. They aren't gonna go for Swindle, and it looks like they will secure themselves 4 kills and just about the Refresh Orb here for the Tidehunter.
Only about 300 gold needed. Well, you had a good fight. Seeing that, like, the two individual fights, he gets 2 kills middle, and then Hyde comes again with the Ravage. Only hits on Z-Freak, but they pick him off, and he had the gem, so.
And every team fight, Complexity just can't quite find farm those heroes to get them some kills. Luckily, Swindle's able to get up to a point mission now, which is great, but. Or his rather.
Yeah, well, once he gets that Octarine, it'll help, but I mean, with only him doing damage running around with Repel, that's gonna do a lot, but they're gonna need that buff, like, buff Aghanim's ulti. It looks like he might be going BKB first, though.
Keeping himself alive, but still. How much it's gonna be affected this game. Weehaw's got his Blink Dagger now, so still looking for that second damaging item after getting the Aghanim's in, and he's almost up to his level 3 ultimate, which is great, but still, like, some sort of damage, whether that's a small crit.
Scotty.
Oh god, Piecat doesn't even go for the shotgun. He says, give me the Scotty instead. Ice Blast will come through and it'll hit on the Z-Freak answer, it looks like. Just barely. I gotta push down mid now.
And AA actually went Diffusal, not Aghanim's, for the Omni Knight.
That is new really one. Nice. Radiant's top tower is under attack. There's no reason not to take this fight now.
From behind,
gonna get stunned up the Adaptive Strike. My cat's gonna go to work and right-click him down, but he does have to repel on him now. Now they're gonna defuse it off, and that's not great. Purification will fly. They might have to use the Guardian Angel here. The Shackle Shot will fly, and he just dies. He'll go down. Meanwhile, jumping in his Flycat. Look at him going to work against Z-Freak. He's got Guardian Angel. He's going to have to purify himself. He'll repel himself as well. They don't have the Diffusal Blade for Flycat. He's just right clicking him down. So tanky. Waveforms up. Elastic will right click. The Guardian Angel will go. And Flycat is corralling them into the base. The Warwick Punch will fly. The Ice Blast will sail through. And Z-Freak will get obliterated by that blast. Now the refresher goes. Ramps will fly through. They'll get Chessie. Four dead. And GG is called. Just like that. And Mama's Boys will move on to the group stages of Captain's Draft 3.0. Congratulations to them. What a series coming out from this Radiant squad.
Yeah, holy smokes. So, I mean, they come in with an 8-game losing, a 4-game winning DC Cavs tournament. They just pushing through in this tournament. They can't stop here.
Yeah, this is their, and you know, it's not even just this tournament. Back when they were called four Clovers
and a Leprechaun.